Hi, this is our stand-up paddleboard quick-release waist belt. The idea behind this is, many of you, if you have a paddleboard, you might have one of these, a traditional ankle leash for your paddleboard. The idea being, if you fall off your board, this is on your ankle, this is attached to the board. If you fall into the water, that you're attached to the board and the board doesn't get carried away, leaving you boardless. So you remain attached to the board. However, it's proven that if you are in white water, moving water, or a couple of other environments, that there can be a hazard caused if you have an ankle leash on, and various scenarios can end up with you stuck in flowing water with your ankle leash on your ankle and you physically unable to release it. You can look on YouTube and see some of these scenarios, but basically the danger is that you become snagged and are unable to release the ankle leash. So for on fast flowing water, what the solution is to use a quick release waist belt. And you take your existing ankle leash, and this doesn't come with an ankle leash, this is an accessory additional to the product you already have. You take your ankle leash, and instead of putting it on your ankle, you pass it through this loop at the back of the waist belt. So you're now attached to it, and this is still attached to your board as normal. And you then put this around your waist, you open the quick release buckle with the toggle, and tighten it up, make sure it's nice and flat, and it's like that. So that should be front and centre with the quick release toggle easy to reach. So this end is still going to attach to your board as normal, and if you fall in the water, you'll remain attached to your board, you'll simply be attached around the waist. However, if you get in a situation where you're snagged in some way and you need to release yourself, it's a simple pull of this buckle, and it doesn't matter how much tension this is under. You know, if I put quite a bit of tension on that, that's all you need to do to get it off. So, recommended for rivers, fast flowing water, white water, anything that the flow of the water is going to cause you a possible hazard, an entanglement risk. This isn't meant to be a training video. We recommend, if you're doing any of these things, that you go and you do some form of paddleboard course and do some training so you can see how properly to use these. If you are using a different type of leash, it doesn't have this bit to strap round it, you've also got a D-ring at the back that you can clip on a different type of leash. With these type of waist belts, best practice is to trim the length of the belt so you don't have extra excess. So if I take that just wearing this t-shirt, you can see I've got quite a bit of extra tail. The recommended length is just to take it round to the logo here and trim it. You can melt the end with a match or a lighter or something so it doesn't fray. That gives you the least possible risk of this becoming entangled itself. However, if you find sometimes you're just in a thin wetsuit, other times you're in a big bulky dry suit with underlayers, or that this belt is used by a multitude of people, that trimming that might not be a viable option to you. But we'll let you know what best practice is. If you've got an individual case where it's only you that uses it and the length of the belt required is static, then best practice is to trim it so you don't have excess flapping around. If you do choose to put it under there, don't tie it in a knot. If you choose to just have it tucked out of the way, it will still release no problem. But don't be tempted to tie it in a knot to keep it out of the way, or you'll defeat the purpose of the quick release. And that's the quick release waist belt for stand-up paddleboards.